Hello, thank you for watching this video. So this is a joint work with Yves Lejean from Paris-Saclay University, and it should be on archive by the day you see this video. So our aim in this work is to study the genetic composition or the genome of all individuals present in the population in a population in which individuals inherit their genomes from two parents who contribute equally in this transmission. As mentioned in a series of papers by John Wakeley, biparental genetic transmission is interesting to study, and it has indeed received some interest. First, in two papers, one by Cheng and one by Derrida and co-authors, dealing with the time to the most recent common ancestor and the genetic composition in a biparental Wright Fisher model. Similar results have been obtained by Linder for the biparental Moran model. Mattson and Evans and Barton and Hetheridge have been studying the link between pedigree and genetic transmission. And finally, Lambert and co-authors have recently studied the impact of a recombination on genome. In this work, we consider a biparental Moran model, which is characterized by its fixed number, large N of individuals. Time is discrete, and at each time step, three individuals are chosen. Two of them are parents. They produce a new offspring that replaces the third individual. This gives a pedigree graph in which gene genealogies will evolve. Now let's consider the main quantities that we will need. For the moment, let's assume that let's fix the pedigree graph here and consider a random walk xn on this graph. So this random walk starts uniformly at time n and moves backwards in time in the pedigree, if necessary, by choosing uniformly between the two parents. Xn can be seen as the history of a gene in the population, and if the quantity An of ij, which is the probability that Xn is equal to j knowing that x0 is equal to y, is the proportion of genome of individual I that comes from ancestor j. That can be seen as the weight of ancestor j in I. Note that this quantity is a deterministic function of the pedigree graph. Here, as an example, I give the weight of all ancestors in the genome of this individual. Now, it's also natural to look at the weight of ancestor J in the whole population, which is the sum of ANIJ over all I. As previously, MN of J is a deterministic function of the graph, or the pedigree. And here I put the weights of all ancestors in the current population. Now, after integrating on all possible pedigrees, Mn of j is a random variable, and for all j, we can prove that Mn of j is a martingale. As Mn of j belongs to 0n, it converges when small n goes to infinity towards a random variable. Our theorem is the following. First, we prove that an of ij converges when small n goes to infinity to a infinity of j, which is independent from I, which means that the weight of all ancestors, of any ancestors, is the same within all individuals living n time step later when small n goes to infinity. So the limiting weight of any ancestor is a random variable, and we prove that when the number of individuals large n goes to infinity, this weight converges in law toward a random variable which is equal to zero with probability 1/2 or follows an exponential law with parameter 1/2. We also prove that the weights of a finite number of ancestors are independent when the number of individuals go to infinity. Now I will give some ideas of the proof of the theorem. For the first point, let us consider the matrix AN that gives the weight of all ancestors in all individuals living N time step later. The AN is a Markov chain, and the transition of this chain or the following way. We choose three lines, and the value of one of these lines is replaced by the mean of the two other ones. This gives that within each column, the maximum value and the minimum value converges almost surely to the same value. This is the first point of the theorem. For the second point, we will prove that the moments of L, let's say the L first ancestors, will converge when N, the weights of L first ancestors converge when N goes to infinity towards the moments of L independent random variables that are equal either to zero with probability 1/2 or follows exponential law with parameter 1/2. To this end, we consider a k particles random walk where k is equal to k1 plus k2 and so on. This random walk is a Markov chain that is irreducible and aperiodic, and it converges, so it converges in law toward a stationary distribution. The link that I denote nu nk, the link between these moments and nu nk is that these moments are equal to n to the power k times nu nk of 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, and so on. We now study these quantities. In fact, the stationary distribution nu nk is invariant under two permutations. First, the permutation of its entries, and second, the permutation of the set 1 to n. Therefore, it's more natural, instead of considering the k-particle Markov chain, to consider a projection of this chain, which gives, for each occupied site, the number of chains that are present at that site. As an example, if the four particles Markov chain is in 1, 2, 2, 3, the projection will be equal to, will be in the state 1, 1, 2. Due to the invariance by permutations that are also true for the model, we have that Yn is itself an irreducible aperiodic Markov chain that converges toward a stationary distribution. And conversely, the stationary distribution of X can be derived from that of Y. So we now study the stationary distribution of the Markov chain Y. To this aim, we use the characterization of the stationary distribution by Freidin and Wenzel in a random perturbation of dynamical systems. So this characterization gives the sum of gives that the limiting probability that a Markov chain is in some state is proportional to the sum of over all trees, all spanning trees that go that point towards that state of the probability of these oriented trees. Now let's take a look at the transition of the chain yk. In fact, on every horizontal line, I put the states that all have the same length, which means states for which the number of occupied sites by the k particle Markov chain is the same. So what we obtain is that the transition probabilities of y are of this form. So the transition probability is of order 1 over n if the number of occupied sites is increased by 1. It's of order 1 over n squared if the number of occupied sites is decreased by 1. It's of order 1 over n squared if the number of occupied sites remains the same but the chain changes state. And finally, the probability of staying in the same state for y is equal to 1 minus something that is equivalent to 1 over n, of order 1 over n. This gives that the probability, the trees that will give the higher contributions here are trees of these forms, this form. So it's a path, descending path from 1, 1, 1 to x, and ascending trees that connect to this path. This gives that the stationary distribution nu nk of x is equivalent to k of x divided by n to the power k when large n goes to infinity. And finally, the stationary equation for nu nk gives that k of x is of the right form. This is the end of the proof of the theorem. We also generalized our results to empirical population and obtained that the limiting weight of ancestors are either equal to zero with probability m minus 1 divided by m or follow an exponential law with parameter 1 over m. We also would like to generalize our results to, for instance, uneven parental contributions or non-uniform mating. And we would like also to consider the distance between the genomes of two individuals in this framework. This is the list of references that I gave during this talk. Thank you for watching and also for organizing this conference. Bye.